Are you wanting to add a virtual background to your Zoom meeting? Do you want to add something a little flashy like this? Or perhaps you want to add some branding like your logo in the upper left-hand corner? Well, in today's video, I want to show you everything you need to know about virtual backgrounds in Zoom. I also want to show you how to create your own custom background using a tool that you probably already have installed on your computer. Hello, everyone. Scott Friesen here at Simpletivity, helping you to get more done and enjoy less stress. And I think perhaps the number one reason for using virtual backgrounds in Zoom is that it hides whatever else is going on behind you. But let's get started with some prerequisites. And some of you have been asking me, why don't I see this virtual background option? I'm going to include a link in the description below for all of the prerequisites so that you can check them yourself. But really, the number one reason is that it comes down to your processing speed. So depending on what machine you are using for Zoom conferencing, if you don't have a fast enough processor, you might not have virtual background capability. But let's make sure that you have virtual backgrounds enabled. And in order to do so, you want to go into your Zoom account. And this is where you would log in as a part of your desktop browser, right? You want to log into your full Zoom meeting account. And under your account settings, we want to go down to the admin section. We want to click on account settings, which is under account management, admin, account management, account settings. And then we want to scroll down to almost halfway down this page. We want to find the subheading, which says in meeting advanced. There's the subheading. If we scroll down just a little bit further, there you go. You're going to see virtual background. You got to make sure that this is turned on in order for you to see that option, in order for you to upload your own images. So once that is the case, you want to go back to your Zoom desktop client. You want to open up Zoom within your computer, hit this little gear icon, and here we have a number of different settings. Now, you may think it's under video here, and if you have virtual background turned on, you'll see it here, but this is not actually where you upload or adjust your virtual background settings. You want to come down here to virtual background, and here you can play around. They do have a few, couple of presets here that you can toy around with. If you do want a video background, you can do so as well. Here you can see I've got the Northern Lights behind me. Just be wary, of course, a video background is going to take up that much more bandwidth and that much more processing speed as well. So you might be safer with using a static image such as this. Now, once you've downloaded a background that you like, all you need to do is select this plus button here to add an image or video. You need to tell it which one that you're adding. If I say add image, I can just go find the image that I want, upload it here, and now I can go ahead and start using that virtual background. However, you're probably saying to yourself, what if I want something a little more custom? What if I want to adjust a few things? What if I want to add a logo, Scott, like you have in your virtual background? Well, you might be surprised to learn that I've created my custom backgrounds, and in fact, I've created an awful lot of my graphics over the years in something called PowerPoint. Yeah, just basic, run-of-the-mill Microsoft PowerPoint. I just find it's a very easy tool to manipulate images, move things around, and create these types of things. So here you can see I've got my custom background here, but let me show you how I made it and how you can make your own as well. The nice thing about PowerPoint is that you're going to have a canvas like this, which is 16:9 ratio, which is pretty standard for most of our webcams and what you're going to want to upload as well. The next thing that you want to do is go online and actually find an image that you like. Now, a place that I go for a number of royalty-free images is a website called pixels.com. And I actually typed in a little bit earlier. I just even typed in Zoom backgrounds. And you can filter by color and that type of thing as well. But I found something a little colorful here that I thought I'd like to try. This one here. It looks like, almost looks like some kind of maybe traffic lights behind glass with some rain. I typically recommend that you choose a background that is darker in color. And the main reason is that you're going to see fewer ghosting lines between yourself and the background image, right? You're not going to see those little white separation lines as it tries to figure out where you end and the rest of the room or the rest of the background begins. So I'm going to click on this image here. And whether you go to Pixels, whether you just go to Google Images, wherever you find your image, in most cases, all you need to do is right-click on the image and then say copy image. You can do this with almost any image online. So I'm just going to say copy image. I'm going to come back into PowerPoint and I'm just going to paste that image here onto my canvas. Now you can see that it's not exactly 16 by 9. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to drag it over here and I'm going to take the corner and just sort of pull it out a bit so it covers the entire space. Now I can bring this up a bit if I want, that to be a little more centered here. I can go up to picture format and actually make sure it's aligned center and aligned in the middle like that. So now it's over my entire canvas. You can see a bit of a preview here on the left-hand side. Now what I could do is now go ahead and use this image. I could have gone straight from pixels and just downloaded the image if I just wanted to go with this image altogether. But I want to add something to it, and that's what I use PowerPoint for. At this stage, I want to input my logo, like you see on one of these slides here. Now, instead of just copying it here, all you need to do is go up to Insert. Let's pretend that I don't have it in this file already. Just say Insert, select Pictures, say from this device. In most cases, it's something that you've downloaded to your device already. And here I've got a transparent version of my logo. You may not have a transparent version, and that's okay. You can use something else that you have or something else that you want to use, but I'm going to use my transparent logo. I'm going to double click on that, which is going to bring it in to PowerPoint, but that is way too big. I don't want that on my virtual background. So again, I'm just going to drag the corner down to a size that I think is maybe a little more appropriate. I'm going to bring it up here to the top left corner. Now, I recommend that you use the top left corner if you decide to add some branding or a logo or anything else that you're adding to your virtual background. The reason is this. At the bottom of the screen, two reasons. Number one, people's names will appear here in the bottom left-hand corner. But number two, and this may be more obvious, is that you and your lower body, right, like your chest and shoulders, are going to be appearing here. So it's going to block out most things that you have in the lower part of the frame. So you want it up top. But the reason why I recommend the top left corner is that in the right-hand side, when other Zoom participants hover over your video, you're gonna see two blue buttons here. You're gonna see the mute, unmute button, and you're also gonna see a more button here, which would cover up anything that is presented on this side. So just to make sure that it never gets covered up, you can put that logo or you can put that image in the top left-hand corner. Now, the last thing that we're gonna do here is we're gonna actually go into full screen mode as if we're giving a presentation, as if we're giving a PowerPoint presentation, and I'm gonna hit print screen. Now, I actually have an additional tool that I use here to capture smaller parts of my screen, but if you don't have such a tool, hitting print screen is just going to capture the entire screen in front of you. It's actually copied to the clipboard, so now we can go anywhere else that we want to, and I use another very simple tool called Microsoft Paint. Yeah, something else that is probably already installed in your computer, and here I'm just going to paste it. I'm just going to paste it here within Paint. The reason why I bring it in here is that it is so easy just to go to File, Save As, and now I can choose the file type, the picture type, that I want to save this file as. And in most cases, you want to look at something like PNG or a JPEG. PNG is often the highest quality that might be available to you in your default program. So I'm going to say Save As PNG Picture. That's going to bring something up here. I'm going to call this Zoom Sample. Let's call this Zoom Sample 2. How about that? And we're going to save that to my desktop. And now all we need to do, I can close this now. We can leave this PowerPoint back open. I'm going to go back into my Zoom meetings here. I'm going to open up my settings, come back down to virtual background, and let's add this background that we just created together. I'm going to hit plus, add image. There is Zoom Sample 2. And hey, yeah, I better watch out for the, I don't know, the ambulance or the vehicle behind me there. And it turns out pretty good. There you can see there's not too much ghosting or shadowing happening amongst my hair or my shoulders or anything of that nature. Now, if for some reason things have been uploaded in the wrong degree, right? If it's rotated in the wrong area, you can come up here and select Rotate 90 degrees and push things around until it finds the one that is right for you. The other thing that you want to pay careful attention to is this Mirror My Video. If this is checked, As you can see, my logo is now backwards, and that is certainly not what I want others to see. So you may just have to toggle this depending on how it uploaded to Zoom. I'm going to uncheck that so that my logo comes across nice and clear. The other checkbox you want to pay special attention to is that if you're not using a green screen, do not check this box. This box is only for green screen only. Why? Because you're going to look something crazy like this. So do not check that box unless you have an actual green screen. And for most of us, we don't have a green screen available or something that we don't want to put up from time to time. Again, if you have proper lighting in front of you against your face, and if it's somewhat darker behind you, or at least an even color behind you, you are going to get the best results here within Zoom virtual backgrounds. Well, I hope that you found today's video helpful. And if you have further questions about Zoom virtual backgrounds or anything related to Zoom meetings, be sure to let me know in the comments down below. Thank you so much for watching. And remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.